Alrighty, OTRSCentral viewers, thanks for going to Twitter and asking questions for this Q&A episode. There were too many questions for me to answer in video form because I just didn't want to sit that long and do one video. So if I did not answer your questions here, I will try to get to them on Twitter. So that way you don't feel like you wasted your time. Nothing worse in this world than wasting your time. And I appreciate, again, those of you that took the time to tweet me. I thank you. But let's go ahead and get started with the questions that made the cut for this video. Carmenade Wins asks, should Roman Reigns get new ring attire, such as underwear or bikini, so that way Vince can get great satisfaction from it? I think Vince goes for like the more ruffian look now. He's out of that boy toy Shawn Michaels phase. He's into that strong, dominant type of guys. And like if Vince and Pat Patterson had their druthers, I'm sure Roman's theme music would change to say powerful, ejaculate, now I swallow, penis. That would probably be Roman's entrance, and it would be flaming bags of dildos that fall down from the sky. I don't know. He probably should get new ring attire, but I don't know if it needs to be underwear or bikini. Are you saying that you want to see Roman's Samoan stud stuff in a bikini? Just wondering, kind of weird. Keys 10, who would be your choice to be the top guy in WWE? To which, at this particular moment, I don't know if there is one. That's the thing. I don't know if there's that true alpha dog. I don't know if there's that guy. So when in doubt, I will default and say, praise God. I don't know. That's a very, very good question. But again, I just don't see that type of guy there on that roster right now. Charles McCain, better at backstage politics, Triple H, Cena, or Hogan? For years, a lot of people wanted to throw Cena as a Breakfast Club member into that true upper echelon and pantheon of great backstage politickers. But ultimately, when there was an opportunity for him to face maybe The Undertaker at WrestleMania, he got saddled in a mixed tag match with his girlfriend and future fiance, future wife, Nikki Bella, against The Miz and Maryse. Roman Reigns got The Undertaker. So we have to cross him off that list. We do. It comes down to Triple H and Hogan. I'm surprised you didn't throw Austin in there, because Austin would have a much better claim than Cena. Are you kidding me? Hogan's the guy that, after all those years of being down in WCW, turning away from WWF/E, trying to help run them into the ground, he comes back. His first program is with The Rock at WrestleMania in the match that steals the show. And yes, while he technically lost there, he managed to pivot out of that NWO role, go back to the old traditional red and yellow Hogan, and got a world title run out of it a month later. That, ladies and gentlemen, that is power. Getting Shawn Michaels to do the job for you at SummerSlam 2005, getting Randy Orton to do the job for you at SummerSlam 2006, that is political power. But then when you look at God, and you say he was able to marry into the family, he gets to bone Stephanie and make daughters. And no matter what, WrestleMania, in large part, will always revolve around his WrestleMania match. And he's always in the mix of one of the top stories, whether it's a Roman Reigns type, a Daniel Bryan type, and who the hell knows where we're going this year with Kurt Angle or Shane McMahon or whatever the hell he wants. God has a lot of power. I don't know if God is in Hogan's class, but he's close. He's really close. Ugh. Best Buy Rick 1. How much better of a career has Ziggler had over Mr. Perfect? I'll give you two answers, and they're right here. How dare you, sir? How dare you? Mr. Perfect is a legend. Dolph Ziggler has stuck around too long to the fact where people just don't really care about him. Even his biggest fanboys now kind of wish he would just go away. So there's the two answers I got for you. Dougish16, ever considered following Jeff Jarrett on Twitter? And if so, what would you post on his Twitter page? Simply no. I would never consider following him on Twitter. But let's say if I did, let's get crazy, let's get nuts. Because I can't get enough of my fill of the Memphis Midcard piece of crap founder. What would I post on his page? Probably all types of ads about local bars in the Tennessee area that were having free cover nights. A bunch of ads from the Quaker Oats website, so that way his wife could see it. Ooh, 2 for 1 on big jars of oats. And then probably spam him with a bunch of pyramid schemes like his 24 karat gold crap. That's probably what I would do. Dave Garcia, should Jim Johnston be in the WWE Hall of Fame? Does Magic Johnson have HIV? There you go. That's your answer. And don't you go crazy triple T conspiracy here and say no, he doesn't. Yes, he does. And yes, Jim Johnston should be in the WWE Hall of Fame. Horror Movie Review 73. How come 80s fans never complained about Hogan going over, but fans complain when Cena did it? In the 80s, the product wasn't nearly as exposed. You didn't have as much TV. You didn't have as many pay-per-views. You didn't have as many featured prominent matches. So when a Hogan wrestled, it was a much bigger deal than when a Cena did. It's also a different era, different time, different perspective and view of wrestling and wrestling fans. So it's phenomenally different than the time that Cena came up in the age of the internet and the smarter fans and the dirt sheets and so on and so forth, where we really talked about backstage politics and political plays and so forth. So that's a major reason why they complained about Cena versus Hogan. And ultimately, Hogan's better than Cena, too, so that's part of it. But I get what you're saying, and I'm not saying it's a completely invalid point, but they're two entirely different eras in professional wrestling. And I would say, to Hogan's credit more than Cena, even though people don't always want to give Hogan this credit, when the time was right at times, he would put the right person over. He most certainly would. He most certainly would, especially during his NWO run, when you're talking about Luger, when you're talking about Sting, the other people that he put over. I mean, there were times Hogan put people over when it was sold to him that it was the right thing to do for business. Hogan was a business guy. Sure, it ultimately had to always fundamentally funnel back to him, but it doesn't mean that he didn't. You know, who the fuck did Austin really put over? A couple of guys, but I'm just saying. Chase Holland. Your favorite wrestling year in the 2010s decade? I'd probably go with 2012, because The Rock beat Cena at WrestleMania. You still had Hogan and Sting and all those people in TNA. I thought that was an incredibly fun year. You still had the old Off the Rope show. The crew was together. Yeah, easily my favorite year was 2012. Lesnar came back. I mean, there's a lot of stuff happened in 2012, so I would go with that year. Richard Collier, will we ever see the full OTRSCentral crew back together again? Permanently? No. One-offs? You never know. Occasional appearances sporadically by different people? I most certainly hope so. The One Jimmy 100, wrestlers who you started liking and then you didn't. Wrestlers that I started liking and then I didn't. John Cena, back in his real actual Thugonomics Eminem phase, when he was a heel and he was rapping, he was talking all types of shit, I thought, oh, this is cool, this is different. And then when he evolved into the Cena that it became in the mid-2000s, that was enough for me. RVD would be another guy that I started off liking in the ECW days, and he started to wear on me and really annoy me in his WWE run, and then when he got to TNA, forget about it, he just pissed me off. You know, the crap of not hooking guys' legs and just some of the other random general crap was very annoying about him. Those are the first two guys that I can think of guys that I started off as fans and then quickly realized that I wasn't a fan of theirs at all, actually. God, who else? Who else? And those are the two I can think of. There's others, I'm sure. I'm just the two that I can think of right now. Dicklonius Games. What doesn't Vince see in Finn Balor that Triple H does? Maybe Triple H sees a good smoking buddy? Triple H looks at Finn Balor maybe as like this tinier underwear model version of God himself, but understands that Finn Balor is never really a physical threat to Triple H? I don't know. Honestly, I don't know what Hunter sees in this kid. Guy. He's 36, he's my age. So he's not a kid. He's a dude. You know, you can talk to Vince about this and talk about the muscles and this and that, but I'm with Vince on this one. I don't see what the hell the big deal is about Finn Balor. So I don't know what the hell Triple H sees that I don't and Vince doesn't, because I most certainly do not see a megastar, period. Jordan, the worst John Cena burial, Nexus at SummerSlam 2010 or Bray Wyatt at WrestleMania 30? I don't even know if that's Cena's worst burial at a WrestleMania. You could throw Rusev into the mix at 31, couldn't you? And debate about that? Oh, easily. It's got to be Nexus SummerSlam 2010. I mean, he ultimately buried an entire faction. That faction was dead after that night. That's one of the worst burials of burials in WWE history, and Cena was the architect of all of that because he just couldn't see past his own bullshit. Mason Clark, is it wrong to hate a family member who did something wrong to somebody else in the family but not myself? No. There's all this talk about, well, you have few things in this world. Family is one of them. Sometimes fuck family, because family will F you quicker than anybody else, because they will feed on the fact that they're family. They will take that love and that admiration and respect and that undying loyalty, and they will stick it to you and put the screws in your back and fuck you over repeatedly and repeatedly. So no, you cannot like things that your family does. You can hate members of your family. Now, maybe it's not the way to go through life, but sometimes it is what it is. Like, if you had somebody in your family, let's say, I'm just using this as an example, that molested somebody else in the family, then yes, you're probably okay to say, I hate him, and he can go the hell away and die for all I care. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. Then he asks, I'm kind of a loner. How do I get up more? Are you okay and comfortable with being a loner? Because if you are, don't worry about it. You know, if you feel like you're socially awkward or you don't really care that much, then don't worry about it. If you do want to change that and affect positive change, then the very simplest answer I could give you, as crass as it sounds, is get off your ass and get out more. Period. Go to places, go to bars, go to clubs. If you golf, go golf. Do any number of things. Just get the hell out of the house. You know, even if you don't build connections and friendships right away, maybe you try to establish some type of like immediate connection if you're trying to work through being a loner, like just engaging people, the male, female, doesn't matter, just some type of conversation and to get you to start slowly progressing and getting over some of these hangups and some of these barriers. Get out more. Stop hiding in your damn house and figure out ways to go out there and be out there. That's simple. Rosario, is wrestling cheesy and terrible because I'm in my 20s, or is it because the product is just that bad? Wrestling for you might now is probably cheesy and terrible because the product is just that bad. I'm with you on that. A product could, in theory, be PG friendly and still be really good for people in their 20s, 30s like me, or 40s or 50s or what have you. But bad is bad. And the WWE product specifically, which I'm assuming you're referencing primarily, is just bad. Because it's just bad. It's that simple. American Alucard, will you watch and review ROH Final Battle? Probably not. I have no interest, no desire to do so. Is that show coming up this weekend? Is it coming up next weekend? I'm really not sure. And to be frank, I don't know that I really care. I just don't have enough interest to watch or review it. Never say never, but probably not. Handsome Hallie, can you see CM Punk ever returning to WWE? For a guy that has prided himself so much on being kind of anti-authority and being better than WWE, not needing it, not wanting it, and being kind of the hypocrite, that personality that he is, I fully expect him to be back. Is it 1 year, 3 year, 5 years, 10 years down the road? I'm not really sure, but Punk's going to come back at some point. I firmly believe that. You know, for us, some of us, we thought Lesnar would never come back, and he did. All these other people over the years we thought would never come back, and they did. What makes CM Punk so different or so special that he won't? Especially if the WWE comes calling with some type of seven-figure payday, or they work out some type of Brock Lesnar-esque part-time deal with him. Why would he not? Because the fighting thing is not going to work. It's a joke. It's a farce. Cool. You put yourself in a position where you were able to go do it. You did it. Great. Wonderful. Hoorah. Who gives a crap? Now get on with it. Go back to doing what the hell you should be doing, which is wrestling. I fully expect him to be back in the company at some point in time. Matt Meffey, who do you see in the final four of the Royal Rumble? Excuse me. You could go down the Shield angle where it's three members of the Shield and maybe Braun Strowman. That's an option. Right now, if I had to guess, I would go Roman, Cena, Strowman, Joe. Cena winning, and Strowman, Joe, Roman having some type of triple threat at that February pay-per-view to determine who would face Lesnar at WrestleMania. That's just a complete guess. Probably the way I would go at this point. Ahmed LW is going to close us out by asking, how many F5s will Roman kick out of at WrestleMania? I think the absolute line on this for over-under has to be 2. And I wonder if it's going to be the over. The only reason it wouldn't be more than 2 is if the match was only like 10 to 12 minutes. But if it goes 15 minutes or more, Roman's probably kicking out of at least 3 of them. It'll be the first one that he kicks out of, and Lesnar and Heyman are going to be like, what the deuce is going on here? Then they'll come back and he'll hit it again, but then he'll try to hit him a second time in a row, and he will do that, and then it still won't matter, and Roman will conquer and go, ooh, ah, and Vince will sit there and get his jollies as you see Roman do this. So my guess right now would be 3. I think the clear over-under is 2, but I will go 3. Because it would just be like WWE to throw that at him too. But anyways, thanks again for those of you that did ask the questions that got on this video. I enjoyed this a little bit, I suppose. And for those of you that asked questions that didn't get answered in this video, I will be hitting you up on Twitter and answering your questions for you. I will see you later.